Good morning, yogis. Sandy Cavalier here. Today's practice will be a low back care practice. I'm going to break it into two parts. So if you just have a few minutes, you can do part one, and then you'll be on your back and taking a final stretch, or you can go to part two, which is some upper back work to strengthen your back muscles, and then some final stretches. So let's start on your back. First thing I want you to do is to notice your low back curve. There's a part of your low back that won't be touching the floor. So see if you can locate that. You might not be able to put your hand all the way under it. It might be very close to the floor, or might be very prominent where your whole hand can fit underneath. So just recognize that. Center yourself on your mat. And to compare your low back curve to not having a low back curve, just press the low back into the floor. You'll feel your whole spine from your tailbone up to your shoulders, not the neck. Behind the neck, there will be a natural curve. And then go ahead and release that and let your low back curve reappear. It's good to just notice what that is. Take a breath in here in neutral. And as you exhale, round the low back into the floor. Breathe into neutral. And exhale, round. So we're doing a little bit of pelvic rocking. You're not exaggerating the low back curve, but you're continuing to just release the low back into the floor. It's a little bit of isolated abdominal work, so you'll feel the work right here behind the navel, not so much in the glutes and the hamstrings. So if you like this, you begin to loosen up the low back. Now come to neutral, breathe in here, and as you exhale, round the low back into the floor, pick the hips up, the mid back, the upper back, take a breath in here at the top, and then slowly roll down, articulating one vertebra, coming to the floor at a time. Feel the low back round into the floor, and on the inhale, the neutral low back comes, so you're not exaggerating. And as you exhale, round the low back, lift all the way up. Take a breath in at the top, and then slowly lower down. We're gonna do a little bit of gluteal work to strengthen the glutes, your gluteus maximus and gluteus medius, which is on the side of the outer hips. And these muscles help to stabilize the pelvis. So lift your hips. First of all, bring your feet in line with your hips so they're not out wide and they're not together. They're right in line with your hip sockets. Your feet are pointing straight ahead. Lift your hips up about an inch, 2 inches, and we're going to do some quick pumps, engaging both glutes strongly. So it's a squeeze, release, squeeze, release, squeeze, release, squeeze, release. That's it. Keep going. We'll do about 30 of them. So squeeze, release, squeeze, release. And notice as you do this, you're also using your hamstrings, the backs of your thighs. Your glutes are getting a good workout. But I want you to notice how much they move the hips. So you see that the glutes do influence hip stability quite a bit. We'll just do 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and now big hip lift. So touch down, lift up, touch down, lift up, all the way down and up and down and up, down, up. And we'll do 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And now alternating glutes. So just squeeze the left and then the right, and then the left and then the right. Keep going, and you'll notice how much the hips move toward the one that is being engaged strongly. Again, showing how much the glutes influence the hips. So now you're just doing alternating hip strengthening. And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, One, and alternating all the way up and down and up and down and up, down. And three, two, one. Okay, now take your feet a little bit wider and turn the toes out, heels in. So now my little toes are touching the edges of the mat. Lift up 2 inches, yep, and we'll start again with both hips, both glutes. Squeeze, release, squeeze, release, squeeze, release. So it's a quick, sharp pump. And you'll see that your hips are lifting again, symmetrically. You might feel a different muscle working. This one is the gluteus medius, a little bit more of that, which is the outer hip. And again, this stabilizes your hips. This is good for your low back because your hips will be just that much more stable. Nice, and then up and down. Mm-hmm. We'll do about 10 of these. So you got 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then alternating hips, just the right, just the left. The same kind of hip dancing you did when your feet were in line with your hips, now they're a little wider. That's how we're targeting a little different muscle group. You might be feeling this now. It's like giving yourself a tetanus shot. And 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and up and down. This is the final group, so make it work. You can do it. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and take a reclining child's pose. So take your knees wide apart, taking them up toward their respective shoulders. Find a glute stretch here, a little pivot side to side. And if that felt super challenging, then I recommend doing it more often. There's two ways to look at challenges. One is as though I'm never doing it again, and the other is maybe I need this more often. Let's take shape four stretch. So cross an ankle over a knee. If this is enough, stay here. If you want a little more, you bring the thigh in towards your chest. If it's difficult to reach behind the thigh, use a strap. So you can take the strap behind the thigh and draw the leg in. And as you draw the left knee in, your mind is pressing your right knee away. So you're not really using your hand or pressure, you're just encouraging it with your mental ability to control your body. The toes are spread, the feet are flexed. Relax the shoulders, the face, and the jaw. So we're stretching the muscles that we just worked. This is also an excellent stretch for some of the internal muscles of the hips. Let's switch sides. So either you use your strap around the back of your right leg, left knee cross, so you can tug in this way and will the outer left knee away, or you can hold on with your hands behind the knee. You could also, if you enjoy it and you're a little more flexible, hug the shin in. So again, I'm willing with my mind, my outer left knee away. So you're stretching some of the external rotators in the inner hip. Some of these muscles surround or either the sciatic nerve goes through some of these muscles or nearby. So this can be a nice release for sciatic discomfort. And release. Take one block between the thighs, hug the block. I'm putting it in the narrow way. Hug the block, bring your feet to the floor. Interlace your hands behind your head, make your head heavy into your hands. Find something to look up at the ceiling so that you don't find yourself cranking your neck. keep the neck long, keep the head heavy. You're just going to lift up the shoulders off the floor. Don't crank the neck. I want you to target the muscles right here between the ribs when they start to split into two sections. So the inhale, the exhale, you lift. Head is heavy, weighted into your hands. The breath in brings you back, and the exhale brings you up. Continue moving. And if you'd like a little more, stay up. And with each exhale, just come up a little higher. So the inhale, you come just a smidge back, and the exhale up higher. And again, my head is really heavy into my hands. See if you can bring the whole shoulder blade off the floor. Your low back curve, you can maintain it, or you can round it into the floor if you need that extra support. So the head is heavy. You're pressing the head into the hands like you're trying to undo the interlace behind the head. Let's do about 10 more. And again, make sure you're not yanking the neck. You're looking up. The back of the neck is long. The head is heavy. You're pressing the head into the hands. And again, you're using that muscle group just below the sternum where the ribs split into two sections. And three. Two, one, and rest. We'll do one more abdominal. I didn't make it clear why we're doing abdominals. And the reason we're doing abdominals is because all of these muscles that surround your rib cage and your chest influence the health of your low back. So if your body is strong from hips to shoulders, your spine will be better supported. For the next set, we'll lift the knees up, and so you're like in a chair pose, but the knees can be closer in. You can round your low back into the floor. Arms out, arms up, arms behind your head, whatever you like. Try not to use your arms. You're just going to go tick-tock across. So the breath in is in the middle, and the exhale, you take your knees to the right, only as far as you can control the motion. Breathing into the top, and breathing out across. So feel your muscles of your abdominals creating this action. So you're not tipping too far that you fall over. You're going only as far as you can that your abdominals, these are your oblique muscles, the side waist muscles are controlling the action. So again, arms can be anywhere you like. Try not to use them. Let this be strictly an isolated abdominal action. So if you want a little bit more, you take your knees a little further away from you. And as you cross over, you might want to add the neck twist, looking opposite the knees. If this makes you dizzy, don't do it. And you might also want to add taking the navel opposite the knees. So it's a little bit more of an abdominal twist. And again, remember, if this bothers your low back at all, keep the low back rounded into the floor. The inhale brings you up, and the exhale takes you across. One more each side. And then remove the block, set it to the side, stretch out, point your toes, reach your arms overhead, interlace the fingers, press the palms away, maybe add a side stretch going in one side, and then the other. So you're welcome to pause the video here and pick up again tomorrow. If you're going for the second set of low back care, then we're going to lay on our bellies. Have a blanket nearby. We'll be going on our knees. And have a strap for some stretches at the end. So let's start out in Sphinx pose. Sphinx pose, you're laying on your belly, and your forearms are underneath your shoulders. Like a proud Sphinx, lift the chest, press the elbows forward, the hands forward, and you'll feel a little more support in the low belly. Draw the shoulders wide so that my shoulders are moving toward my hips. Pressing forward with the hands will keep the low belly engaged. All 10 toenails are on the floor. The shoelaces, where they would be on my feet, that's pressing into the floor. I'm drawing my collarbones wide. My shoulder blades are on my back, and I'm pressing the tips of the shoulder blades in. If you start to feel this in your low back, then press your elbows forward more so that you feel a lift in the belly and the side waist. Feel the network of muscles working on your back. Draw the shoulder blades toward each other as though they are connected to two drawstrings, and you're pulling the drawstrings more and more tight. And then go ahead and rest your forehead on the floor. Take your arms in goalpost shape so that your elbows are in line with your shoulders and your forearms and hands are on the floor. Relax your legs and your glutes. You're going to use a little bit of glute action, but not much. So press your toenails down. Press the shoelace area down. On the inhale, lift your chest, your arms, your shoulders, your head, but look down. And on the exhale, rest. Continue. Inhale. Everything lifts. Make sure the glutes are not engaged strongly. And exhale. Inhaling up. Feel the upper back work and lower down. Inhale up. Hug the shoulder blades together. Exhale, lower. Inhaling up. Exhaling lower. So you're strengthening the back muscles, which help you stand up straight. And when you stand up straight, your low back has the ability to create its natural curve. When our upper back is rounded, we tend to lose the low back curve. It becomes rounded and it doesn't have a healthy shape. Just do two more if you can. And now child's pose. So press up and back. Take the knees wide. If your knees bother you in child's pose, as mine do, I stay up high in my child's pose. I stack my arms and rest my head here. But you can go as deep as you like in your child's pose. And then come up onto all fours. Pad up your knees if you like. I'm going to do bird dog pose, which is another opportunity to strengthen your whole core, shoulders to hips, lifting the front body up and engaging the back body to create a long spine. So from the tailbone right through the top of my head, I'm pressing my hands forward to create a little more stability. Try that. Press your hands down and then press them forward and see how that engages your core. Now roll the outer shoulders towards your hips. Lift the belly up. You can kickstand your feet by standing on the balls of the feet for a little more stability, or you can press the shoelace area down. You choose what you'd like. I'm going to go for a little more stability today. Lift the front body again. Stretch the mat forward. Take your left foot back. Stand on the ball of the foot. Lift the belly once more, and then lift the leg. Spread the toes. Reach through the ball of the foot. Firm the thigh. Stretch the mat forward with your left hand, come to your right fingertips, create the stability you need, and then reach your right arm forward. Let's take three breaths here. Continue pressing the left hand forward, firming the lifted leg, lift the belly up, lift the core. One more breath. And then hand down, knee down. Prepare for the second side. So the hands are placed firmly. Now the right hand is stretching forward.
and take the right leg back. Again, lift the belly, press the mat forward so that the core is engaged, shoulders are working towards your hips, the back is flat, and then lift the right leg. Spread the toes, firm the thigh, and continue lifting the belly for support for your low back. Come to the fingertips of your left hand so you're ready to take the balance. And when you are, take your left arm forward. Continue stretching the mat with your right hand. Keep the core engaged. Keep the back leg lifted. The thigh is strong. It's keeping the leg straight. Let's take one more breath. Continue stretching the mat forward with your hand. And then hand down, knee down. Your version of child's pose. Feel how child's pose offers a nice stretch for the low back. And now we'll take some seated stretches. So you can move the blanket. Keep your strap handy. We'll be using it in the next section. Z pose on the right. So sitting firmly on your thigh, bring your front shin parallel with the front of the mat. You can stay up high. You can frame the front foot, hand to knee, hand to foot, pull the chest forward. You could lower down onto blocks, and you can lower down onto the floor. It is nice to have a block underneath your forehead when you rest in this pose. So you find your meaningful stretch. If you need more in the stretch, you can take the front leg back behind you. I keep my toes curled under and the knee just slightly touching the floor because of all my knee issues. So be sure and accommodate yourself in this pose. You want to feel a stretch, but you don't want it to be so intense that you can't breathe smoothly, that your jaw is relaxed, your shoulders are relaxed. And as you relax into this, you might feel that you could go even a little deeper. So pulling the chest forward. And now we'll switch sides. Oh, actually, we're not switching sides. We're going to take a thigh stretch, which contributes to low back health. So take your hand to your front ankle and pull it all the way in. Rest out on your right hand. Take the left knee back, really lean out, catch the back ankle. You can stay here if you're getting enough of a stretch. If your low back is tweaky, you'll turn your chest to the long side of your mat. If your low back is healthy and happy, you can turn the chest and hips forward. If you want more, you take the knee further behind, point the toes to your back knee. Lift your hip points. Your hip points are just at the top of the pelvis. Lift them up so you're drawing your low ribs towards your hips. So you're stretching your thigh muscles, your quads, which is very difficult to get into other than in a shape like this and a few others, but this fits nicely with our sequence. So stretching the thigh muscles is important because they attach to the hip, one of them specifically. And this muscle group being tight can pull the hips into an exaggerated low back curve. So if this feels absolutely awful, then again, I say maybe you should do this more often as opposed to thinking I'm never doing this again. So take it to a very tolerable place that you're getting a beneficial stretch, something that you could return to again tomorrow. Let's take a twist within this sequence. Bring the back foot around, stand on the foot in front of the shin. Put both sit bones on the floor. If it feels appropriate, you could take your front leg over the thigh and again press the sit bone down. The third choice is to take your right leg long on the floor. So pick one of the three that suits you best. The left hand goes behind, so it's the same hand as knee. The opposite arm hugs, so it's a twist. And if you press your sit bone down and draw the knee across your chest, you'll get an outer hip stretch. So all the muscles of the legs need to be stretched as well as strengthened for a healthy low back. Breathe in, lift up, and then exhale, twist. One more. And then let's take the whole sequence on the other side. Sitting on your left thigh, take your right knee a little bit behind, lean out to the left, and maybe this is your spot on this side. We're very different on each side. So if you want more, hand frames knee and foot, pull the chest forward, maybe you stay here, maybe you go onto blocks, maybe you lower onto the floor. As I said, it's really nice to put a block under the forehead. And if it's appropriate, on this side, you start to wiggle the back leg back further. You might feel this stretch in lots of different places. It might be in the outer hip of your front leg. It might be in the front thigh of your back leg. So there's lots of muscles that can contribute to participate in this stretch. Make sure that none of them is causing too much sensation. You want to be able to breathe smoothly, finding a four-part breath, a soft inhale, a pause, and a soft exhale, and a pause. Check in to see that you're not clenching your jaw, you're not tensing your shoulders, and that you can relax into this and enjoy the stretch. So take it to a place that becomes enjoyable. Now we'll come into the thigh stretch. So lean way out on your left hand. Take your right hand to the ankle and draw the ankle all the way in. Point the toes to your back leg. Lean out far enough, bend your elbow so you can catch the back ankle. And again on this side, if your low back is tweaky, turn your chest and hips to the long side of your mat. If your low back is fine and happy, turn the chest and hips forward. Lift the hip points up so you're bringing your low ribs closer to your hips. If you want more, you take the knee further behind. And breathe into this so that your breath is smooth and easy, taking the stretch as deep as you would like. And again, you're stretching a network of muscles that gets tighter and tighter through the use of the legs. One of the muscles that you're stretching crosses the hip joint, and as I mentioned on the other side, can tip the pelvis so that your low back curve becomes over exaggerated. And now we'll go for the twist, A, B, or C. So one is foot in front of the shin, both sit bones on the floor. The deepest would be crossing over, both sit bones toward the floor. And the third one would be to straighten out the front leg with your right leg crossed over. Take your right hand behind, come to the fingertips, lift up. Your left hand will hug the knee, press the right sit bone down, and draw the knee across your body. Lift up on your breath in, and then twist your chest. So this is providing a healthy spine by twisting. You're also stretching muscles internally that cross over the hips and can contribute to low back discomfort. In addition, you're getting an outer hip stretch. And then unwind yourself. Find your strap, and we'll do three leg stretches on each side. Knees are bent, feet on the floor. We'll strap up the left leg first today. So take the foot up to the ceiling. I like to wrap my wrists, my hands around the strap, and let my arms serve as weights so I'm not clenching up and trying to hold on to the strap with too much effort. Taking the strap toward the ball of the foot, drawing the foot
closer and closer toward my chest. My right foot is very stable on the floor. See if you can make your left side waist as long as the right. When you take the leg up, we shorten the waist. So see if you can roll the outer hip toward the front of your mat. Now, can you recreate your low back curve? When you take the leg up, we round the low back. See if you can recreate the low back curve, finding, again, a safe stretch, something that is somewhat enjoyable, so that you'll remember to do it again tomorrow. This is a great sequence before bed. Brings a lot of calm to the body and releases a lot of tension in the legs. Now take the straps into your left hand, lift the toes of your right foot, and spill to the right outer edge of the foot. So you're on the little toe side with the toes lifted. The knee is coming out to the side. Your left leg is going to come out to the side, so you can get a stretch on both inner thighs this way. My left elbow's on the floor, helping me keep some control over the leg so I'm not plunking over to the side. Taking my foot, rotating toward the ceiling, toes toward the floor, and the foot up toward my shoulder. See if you can keep both hips on the floor. Breathing softly. No pulling on the inner knee. Keep the slightest bend in the knee. And now straighten out the right leg on the floor. Bring the left leg up. Switch hands with the strap. So again, here I go for rolling it around the hand. I'm close to the wall, and actually this is an awesome approach to this stretch. Press the foot into a wall. Find some resistance pressing away from the wall. Now I've got a really nice deep stretch that's pretty effortless. I'm simply pressing into the wall. You can look opposite the foot, opposite the leg, taking a little upper body twist. Again, my elbow is bent and my hand is helping just to control the stretch, but really on this side, I'm just pressing into the wall. It is delicious. And yes, my left hip is off the floor. There's other ways to do this stretch, keeping the hip down to get into different tissue, which you're welcome to try, keeping both hips down and slightly taking the leg across. And then bend the knee, come back up, and we'll switch sides. I'm going to turn around so that I can enjoy the stretch pressing into the wall again. So now we'll bend the knees, feet on the floor. I'll strap up the right leg, bringing the strap around the ball of the foot. Twisting the strap around my hands so that my hands are weights. Both hips are down. And because I lost the low back curve when I lifted the leg up, I'm going to reestablish the low back curve. And now I'm going to roll my outer right hip toward the end of my mat so that my hips feel square and level and my right side is as long as my left. And there are different ways to stretch. You could bend the knee, bring the leg in closer and then straighten. So play around a little bit with what feels best and most effective. Notice your breath. It's smooth, it's long, it's controlled. There are pauses at the top of the breath and a pause at the bottom of the breath. Now lift the toes of the left foot. Turn to the outer edge of the foot so the knee goes out to the side with the toes lifted. Take the straps into the right hand. Take the leg out to the right, up toward the right shoulder and turn the heel toward the ceiling. Keep the slightest bend in the right knee so that you're not feeling any pulling whatsoever on the inner knee. Now straighten out the left leg, bring your right leg up and over, switch hands with the strap,
And again, I'm going to enjoy using the wall for resistance. Your right arm is out, right palm is up. Stretching length on my right side waist, pressing firmly into the wall, or you're pulling against the strap. Elbow bent so that your hand is in a comfortable position to hold on to the strap. I'm looking opposite my leg that's over the top, so I get a little twist in the neck, a little bit of rotation. And again, my right hip is off the floor in this version of this twist. So the resistance pressing into the wall for me is absolutely delicious. And then bend the knee, come back up, release the strap, and you're welcome to take a little rest in Shavasana, staying as long as you like. Notice how your low back feels, and notice how your legs feel. And rest here as long as you like.